What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel.
If you're in the computer science domain, you definitely have heard of design patterns before, or even used a few patterns in practice, with or without your knowledge. But really, what are design patterns? Why were they created in the first place? And who decided to create them? What is actually the main purpose behind design patterns? All these questions and more will be answered in this first video of our design pattern series, to which later we will add more videos detailing each pattern on its own. As always, and to better understand the concept at hand, let's take a practical example. And let's imagine a steak. You see, I may have imagined a well-done steak. You may have imagined a medium-done one. Someone else might have imagined a vegan steak. While ordering a steak at a restaurant, each one of us orders it differently. We don't all necessarily have to order or eat our steak the same way. And yet, the cook that is preparing it will take the same piece of meat or soy in addition to the way or policy of how we like our steak and prepare a delicious meal, a different one for each one of us, using the same piece of meat as a starting point. To compare this to a computer program, suppose we have a chef class with a prepare method. This method can take a well-done instruction object, and in this prepare method, the chef will know how to prepare a well-done steak. But what about other ways of preparing a steak? We will have to overload this method to take in a medium-done instruction and a vegan instruction. Okay, now our chef knows how to cook all the steaks we want. Let's say this chef extended his knowledge and now knows of 5 additional ways to cook a steak. Should we add 5 more methods? Well, let me suggest something else. Why not replace all these methods with a single method that takes a steak cooking instruction and let all these classes inherit this one? What do you think? Isn't that a better design for our chef class? You see, this way our class is closed for modification and open for extension, which means that not only we won't have to add any more methods nor even touch our chef class in the future, but in addition to this, when a new instruction is needed, all we have to do is extend the steak cooking instruction class we created with this new instruction, and the prepare method will handle it automatically. Now, because of our design, this chef apparently skyrocketed and decided to open a new branch for the restaurant. So, every time a new customer enters the restaurant, the chef goes ahead and informs them of the opening date and details for the new branch. But do you think that is the best approach to deal with such a scenario? Don't you think that instead of waiting for people to come in, the chef should have instead messaged all his customers the details about the opening, or even posted on social media, and those interested would have showed up? Wouldn't this reach be far larger? In both previous scenarios, the solutions I suggested hint at a specific pattern. This pattern will not actually solve our problem and generate magically ready code for us, but rather it will give us a description or template to follow, a way of thinking that will help us solve these problems, like a series of formalized best practices, steps that programmers have followed and used to solve common problems like the one we just encountered. Design patterns best became known from the Design Patterns book by Eric Gamma, Richard Helm, Ralph Johnson, and John Vlissidis, often referred to as the Gang of Four book, published in the mid-90s. Now, this book details 23 design patterns, which were split into 3 groups: creational patterns, structural patterns, and behavioral patterns. Creational patterns deal with the creation of objects. Instead of you instantiating all objects very specifically and explicitly, they give you more flexibility in how the objects are actually created. Let's suppose that we have a class with 10 attributes, but not every time we create an object based on this class, we need to specify all 10 attributes. Sometimes we only need 1, in other cases 3 or 2, and sometimes 8 or 9. In such cases, we are left with 2 solutions, and not quite the best out there. Either to create a lot, like a lot, of overloaded constructors for our class, or create 1 constructor that takes all arguments. But then we will need to pass as null values the ones we don't require upon creation of our objects. Well, design patterns will tell you, wait, you have a third option. Follow the template provided by the builder pattern. A template widely used and tested by many developers out there. Well, if I were in your shoes, I'd pick this last option. Structural patterns deal with how classes are actually designed, with how things like inheritance and composition and aggregation can be used to provide extra functionality. Let's consider that in our application we are storing book objects, and these books, well, there's too many of them. Like in the 100,000 books of a library or the books in all of Amazon online store. And for some reason, we need to represent each book by an object. You see, in this case, we will have a bunch of book objects that will share the same attributes. And by bunch, I mean in the thousands, which will have the same author, the same Amazon physical storage location, same places it can be delivered to, same provider, etc. You got the idea. And maybe the only attribute that will differ is the title itself and the price in some cases. So why create for each book an object and consume all this amount of memory, while at the same time, if we follow the template specified by the flyweight pattern, we will be able to minimize memory usage by sharing as much data as possible between our similar objects. You see, that is what design patterns are trying to do. They are trying to provide us with a schema, a step-by-step definition or template to help us overcome development or architectural problems that others have faced before us. Finally, behavioral patterns are specifically concerned with communication and assignment of responsibilities between objects as the program is running. The two examples we gave at the beginning of our video can actually be solved using two different behavioral patterns, one of them being the strategy pattern. Let's take a second example and suppose we realized that the state of an object in our application will be changed by a lot of other objects, but we needed to be able to undo the last change. Well, this can be done in many different ways, and you are free to use any of them. But there is a memento design pattern that describes a simple, proven approach. So, to sum up, design patterns will speed up your development process by providing tested and proven development models. At first, you may not notice that you require the use of this pattern here or there, or you may make use of it without even knowing, but with time, practice, and hopefully with the help of our videos, you will. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.